Welcome you all to my channel Krishnavik. Today, I am going to show you how you can protect your files or directories from accidental deletion. This method also can prevent root user to delete file or directory unwillingly. This technique is very helpful when you share any important file or directory over the network. Through this technology, you also can secure many system files such as passwd, shadow, and so on. I am going to perform this practical on the Red Hat Enterprise Linux 8 system, but if you're using RHEL 9 or any other Linux OS, such as Fedora, Ubuntu, CentOS, Alma Linux, etc., process is same. In the beginning, I need to create a directory and few files under that directory to your better understand. Type the following command to create a directory named test0. Now, through the touch command, I am going to create multiple files under the test0 directory. Let's check. Yes, 9 files are created successfully. All files are empty. Now, through the following command, I am going to add a text line as a content in any of a file. Suppose I have chosen here file 5.txt as a target file. Let's check. Okay, file 5.txt has been edited with the text content successfully. Type the following command to display the attributes of the files under the test0 directory. This command provides information about the attribute set on each file or directory, indicating whether certain attributes are set or not. Okay, there are no attributes set yet. Let's set an attribute on file 5.txt through the following command. This sign means add append-only attribute. It's allowing data to be added to a file but not removed or modified. Let's check. Okay. Through the following command, I am trying to add a new text content by removing its existing contents. Operation not permitted. But if I try to append a new text content with existing contents, no error message. Let's check through the cat command. Perfect, text content has been added successfully. Let's see few more aspects of it, such as, if you try to move this file to another directory, you can't, but you can copy this file. Let's check. Copied file is working perfectly. Attribute won't enable over the copied file. If you try to create a hard link of this file, you can't. But if you try to create a soft link, it's allowed you. Let's check. Yes, soft link has been created successfully. If you try to remove this file, operation not permitted. Or if you try to rename this file, you can't. Operation not permitted. Let's check. If you check attributes of all files under following directory, you can see only file 5.txt has attributes. It means other files can be deleted. Let's type the following command to delete any other file, such as file 9.txt. File 9.txt has been deleted successfully. Next experiment. I am writing a text line as a content into the file 6.txt. Let's check. Okay, the file has been edited successfully. Type the following command to enable an attribute on file 6.txt. This sign means add immutable attribute. It's preventing any modifications to the file. Let's check. Yes, immutable attribute is successfully enabled on the file 6.txt. Now, you can't modify this file. Let's try to edit this file now. Nope. Operation not permitted. Let's try to append content into this file. Operation not permitted. Let's try to rename this file. Operation not permitted. Let's try to move this file. Operation not permitted. But you can able to copy this file. Let's see the file content. Okay, let's try to create hard link of this file. Operation not permitted. But soft link can be created. Let's see. Yes, soft link has been created successfully. If you try to remove this attribute enabled file, unwillingly, you can't, no matter you have sudo or root privilege. Let's check. File is intact. Now, I am going to show you how to remove a particular attribute from a particular file. Type the following command lines to remove the attribute from file 5.txt and file 6.txt, respectively. Done. Now, no file has any attributes. Let's see how we can enable an attribute on the directory. Type the following command to enable the append attribute on the directory named test0. Now, if you try to delete the test0 directory, you can't. Operation not permitted. All files are intact. Let's try to delete individual file under the test0 directory. You can't, because the attribute which has applied on the test0 directory has been protecting all files from deletion. But in this scenario, you can create content in any file. You can modify the content in any file. Or you can append content in any file. Let's check. Perfect. You can't move files from here. But you can able to create hard and soft link of files. Let's check. Yes, links are created successfully. You can able to copy file. Let's check. Perfect. But you can't remove file in spite of you have the root privilege. If you really want to delete files from here, then you have to disable the attribute first. Type the following command to disable the append attribute over the test0 directory. Now, type the following command to remove a file, such as file 3.txt. Let's see the status. Yes, file 3.txt has been removed successfully. Type the following command to enable an attribute to all files at a time within a directory. Here I am using append attribute and test0 directory. Let's check. All files are enabled with append attribute. As a root user, if you unwillingly try to remove the following directory, directory has not gotten any harm, and all files under the directory will be intact. And when you want to remove this directory, or its file, simply disable the attribute protection over the directory. Type the following command to disable an attribute of all files at a time, within and with a directory. Let's check. Attribute protection has been removed upon the directory along with all files within it. Now, if you wish, you can modify or remove test0 directory or any files within it. The commands we have used here are typically available on most Linux distributions that use the extension 2, extension 3, or extension 4 file systems, as these commands are related to file system attributes. Here is a list of popular Linux distributions where you can execute these commands. Please note that these commands are associated with the extension 2, extension 3, and extension 4 file systems, so they may not be available on distributions that use different file systems by default. Additionally, while these commands are widely available, there might be some minor variations or additional attributes depending on the specific distribution and version. You can check the documentation or manual pages of the commands on your distribution for precise details.